Okay, Assalamualaikum brothers and sisters. So, in this video, we're going to cover common emitter where there is emitter resistor at the emitter terminal. Okay, so in the last video, I have introduced the BJT amplifier and we have concluded that in order to calculate R0, Rπ and Gm, you need to find out what is the DC collector current, IC. Okay, and also in that video, I have derived the open circuit voltage gain for common emitter grounded, which is this equation, and then the input resistance is Rπ parallel with RTH, and the output resistance is R0 parallel with RC. Okay, so now let's look at type number 2, common emitter with emitter resistor. So you can see here your emitter terminal is connected with RE. Okay, normally in this configuration there is no R0. Okay, R0 is infinity, which means that your early voltage is infinity as well. So in this configuration, there is a new parameter called input resistance seen from the base, RIB, which is equivalent to VB over IB. So you're going to see RIB in one of the steps. Okay, so I would like to compare your common emitter grounded here, okay, and in this configuration there is RE. Okay, so you can see this circuit is a bit complicated, so that's why we need to introduce RIB in this calculation later. Okay, so you can see here the steps for the output side are the same, but R0 now equivalent to RC because the small R0 is infinity, and then therefore your output voltage is just equivalent to minus RC GM VBE. Okay, so this is where it's a bit tricky because now you need to calculate what is the RIB. So RIB is equivalent to Rπ plus 1 plus beta RE. So you need to memorize this formula to calculate RIB. Okay, so because you have created this input resistance seen from the base, so your input resistance now equivalent to RTH parallel with RIB. In comparison with your common emitter grounded, RI is equivalent to Rπ parallel with RTH, kan? But for this configuration, your RI equivalent to RTH parallel with RIB. Next, your input signal VI, okay, is equivalent to this equation. So this equation is derived by KVL. So if you look at this slide here, okay, if I want to find VI, I have to do the KVL at this loop, okay, which is VBE plus the voltage across RE minus VI, kan? But first, I need to know what is the current flowing through your RE. So if I do KCL at this node, it's GMVBE plus the current flowing through your Rπ. So the current flowing through your Rπ is VBE over Rπ, Ohm's law, kan? So that's how I get the current flowing through your RE, okay, which is here VBE over Rπ plus GMVBE, and then I multiply with RE. So finally I can get the KVL equation, and then when you simplify, the equation is reduced to VBE multiply with RIB over Rπ. So now let's look at one example. So you can see here again the voltage divider configuration is used, and you can see that there is RE connected to the emitter terminal. Beta is 120, VBE is given as 0.7 volt, and VA is infinity. So when VA is infinity, your R0 will be infinity as well. So you can see here I have calculated the RTH and VTH. Okay, and remember we are not going to connect this input signal first, because during this analysis your capacitor is open circuit, so we are only going to concentrate on this portion for your DC analysis. So I did my BE loop, okay, in order to get my IC over here, and I calculate the parameters Rπ, GM, and we know already that R0 is infinity. I'm going to show how we transform this on the whiteboard and proceed with the next analysis straight away until we get the AVOC, and then I will continue until we get the Vout over VS. So these four slides, I'm going to present it on the whiteboard, okay?
A few moments later.
So this is your circuit, and as usual, you need to turn off VTH and VCC. And now I'm going to do the AC equivalent. So this is your base, collector and emitter. So Rπ, the current source, and R0. Okay, don't forget your Vout is measured at the collector terminal, so this is your Vout from this point to ground. Okay, for common emitter with RE, your R0 is infinity. Okay, R0 infinity
equivalent to open circuit. Okay, so I'm going to just remove this R naught from this AC equivalent. Okay, so all you are left with is this. After you have done this, we are going to connect with the other resistors. So this time, let's start with RE. So RE is connected to emitter terminal, to ground. Okay, so RC is connected between collector terminal and ground. Okay, so this is my RC, and this is my VCC off. So as for base, RTH and ground as well. And this is my VTH off. So my GMVBE is here, okay, and my VBE this time is here. So you can see that in the first type, when your emitter is grounded, your emitter is directly connected to ground, but this time there is RE. So remember in the first video I mentioned that VI is the voltage at the base terminal, okay? So my VI is here. And this time, VI is not equivalent to VBE due to the emitter resistance. So now let's do the steps to derive the AVOC. So, same thing, there's output side and input side. So R0 this time is just RC, okay? Because there is no small R0, the output resistance is equivalent to RC. So the second step is finding your Vout, okay? So this is my RC, and this is my RE, right? Okay, and this is my Vout, right? So although you have RE, the current that flows through your RC is still GMVBE, okay? So your Vout is still equivalent to minus GMVBE multiplied with RC. Okay, and don't forget the minus sign because the current still flows in this direction, but the voltage is measured from this point to this point. Okay, so don't forget the negative sign. So this is your output side, which is similar to the first two steps when your emitter is grounded. Okay, so the third step is the calculation of RIB. So this is the extra step for common emitter with RE. Because you have this emitter resistance here, you have to include the parameter of RIB, input resistance seen from the base. In the first type, when your emitter is grounded, it is straightforward because RTH is parallel with RPi, but not in this case because of this resistor here. RPi and RE are not in series because we have this branch here, so they are not in series. Okay, so that's why we have this parameter here. I don't want to go too much into detail on how we derive RIB. Just remember that for common emitter with RE, you have to calculate what is input resistance seen from the base, RIB. Right? So I'm going to wipe this part. So step number 3 is calculating input resistance seen from the base, RIB, which is equivalent to RPi plus 1 plus beta RE. Okay? So step number 4 is representing VI in terms of VBE. Right? So I have explained on how we get to that, the KVL and so on. So VI is equivalent to VBE multiplied with RIB over RPi. So basically, for this configuration where your common emitter has the emitter resistor, these two steps are the critical one where you have to remember how to calculate RIB and how to represent VBE and VI. Okay, so the last step before we derive AVOC is RI, input resistance. Okay, so once you've done step number 3, your input side is basically as follows. Okay, so this is what happened when you have simplified the input side to have this resistance. So RI will be equivalent to RTH in parallel with RIB. So this is the input resistance, and next we can derive the AVOC. So, to derive AVOC, always go back to the voltage amplifier block. So, AVOC VI and this is my VI and my Vout. Okay, so AVOC VI is equivalent to Vout. Alright, so AVOC equivalent to minus GM VBE RC. But what is VI? This is VI, right? Okay, so VI is equivalent to VBE RIB over R pi. So you can cancel your VBE and you are left with, so AVOC is equivalent to minus GM RC R pi over RIB. So that is the derivation for the open circuit voltage gain. Okay, so we have established that AVOC to be equivalent to minus GM RC R pi over RIB, where the values are minus 16.06, your RC is 6 kilo ohm and R pi is 7.46 kilo ohm, and RIB can be calculated using the equation R pi plus 1 plus beta multiply with RE. Okay, so the question provides beta to be equivalent to 120 and RE is equivalent to 0.6 kilo ohm. Okay, so therefore RIB is equivalent to 7.46 plus 121 multiplied with 0.6, and you will get 80.06 kilo ohm. So back to the open circuit voltage gain, AVOC equivalent to minus 718.85 over 80.06, and I will get minus 8.98. So this is my open circuit voltage gain, which I will use to calculate what is the voltage gain V out over VS. Okay, so this is my voltage amplifier and I have connected the amplifier with the input signal VS. Okay, so since there is no load, my AVOC VI is equivalent to V out. Okay, because there is no load. Alright, so we have calculated AVOC to be equivalent to minus 8.98, and VI is the voltage divided equation at the input side, which is equivalent to RI, RI plus RS multiply with VS, and this equivalent to Vout. Okay, so the voltage gain Vout over VS is equivalent to minus 8.98 R in, R in plus RS. So this is the equation for your voltage gain. But first we need to calculate what is RI. So RI is equivalent to RTH parallel with RIB. And you can refer back to your slides. RTH equivalent to 57.7 kilo ohm. And we have calculated RIB to be 80.06 kilo ohm. Right? And you will get 33.53 kilo ohm. So now I can put this value inside this equation and I will get the gain to be equivalent to minus 8.98, 33.53 over 34.03, and the answer is minus 8.58. So this is my voltage gain, V out over VS, right? So this is the solution for the example in your slides. And I plan to show one or two more examples during our discussion later. So I'll see you in the next video for the type number 3, common emitter with bypass capacitor CE. Okay? So I'll see you then. Take care. Bye. Assalamualaikum.